Good morning, everyone. My name is Arec Manoukian, and I am a senior research associate at Lunaphore, a biotechny brand. I am very happy to present this poster about a novel same-section multiomics approach combining RNAscope by ACD and sequential immunofluorescence on the COMET platform by Lunaphore. To go over the background, it is important to note that spatial biology techniques have revolutionized our approach towards studying the tumor microenvironment and its complex cellular interplay. By preserving the spatial information and allowing analysis at single cell resolution, an unprecedented understanding of the cellular composition of cancer tissues has been made possible. On the one hand, multiplex immunofluorescence methods have enabled precise profiling of immune cells and other key cellular players of the tumor microenvironment while uncovering their spatial distribution and interactions. On the other hand, in situ hybridization technologies have been shown to provide complementary information to protein profiling, such as the mapping of cytokines and chemokine expressing cells. These are essential to comprehend signaling networks and immune activation statuses. For the methods over here, we leverage the novel multiomics approach that combine these two biological inputs to achieve same-section co-detection of RNA and protein targets. The combined workflow is a fully automated on COMET, an advanced tissue staining and imaging platform. Here in the first figure, we want to showcase that through precise control over temperature and reagent distribution, COMET ensures each assay's maximum efficiency and reproducibility. Over here in panel A, COMET is an automated platform providing a slide-in, data-out workflow for spatial biology analysis of up to four tissues simultaneously. Next to it, in panel B over here, we showcase Lunaphore's fast fluidic exchange technology, which allows fast and uniform delivery of reagents to a closed staining chamber, enabling high-quality results within minutes instead of hours. And here, in the last panel over here, I would like to walk you through the new automated workflow combining RNAscope, HiPlex Pro, and sequential immunofluorescence on COMET. First, as you can see here at the beginning, samples are de-waxed and targets are retrieved with the new multiomics optimized retrieval protocol before samples and reagents are loaded on the COMET. From there on, the protocol is fully automated with RNA detection first, followed by protein detection and image preprocessing. The output image is an automatically stitched, aligned, and flat field corrected to build a standard OME TIFF file, which can be directly imported and analyzed using any third-party analysis tool or custom pipelines. Over here, for the RNA parts, we built on the RNAscope HiPlex chemistry. To make this assay multiomics ready, we integrated ACD's latest protease-free pre-treatment technology, enabling robust and specific protein detection while maintaining highly sensitive RNA detection with RNAscope. And we call this assay RNAscope HiPlex Pro. First, target probe pairs bind, followed by cascade of amplification probe hybridizing, building to the so-called amplification tree, culminating in the binding of flow for labeled probes. RNA is detected in cycles of four. Thereby, dilabeled probes of one cycle are cleaved after the fluorescent signal is imaged and before the next set of dilabeled probes binds. RNAscope HiPlex is a universal application allowing for the detection of any gene in any species of interest. You can select from catalog probes or with ACD's made-to-order service, you can design probes for virtually any genes of interest. Since RNA detection is based on the RNAscope HiPlex chemistry, you can build panels with up to 12 RNA targets and up to 28 protein markers. The whole workflow is very gentle to the tissue, and you can continue using the sample after a multiomics experiment and do downstream HNE, HSC, or other sequencing assays. Once the RNA is spatially mapped, proteins are detected based on COMET's sequential immunofluorescence approach. It follows a similar cyclic principle of staining, imaging, and elution. First, up to two proteins are stained with standard primary and secondary antibodies. After the imaging step, the whole antibody complex is gently eluted before the next antibodies bind. As you can see, there is no proprietary chemistry, and the user has an open choice of antibody selection thanks to the use of standard primary non-conjugated antibodies. This allows users to transfer their antibody knowledge they collected at the bench. The integrated multiomics protocol presented here allows up to 3 RNAscope detection cycles combined with 12 sequential immunofluorescence cycles for a total of 12 plex RNA and 24 plex protein panel in less than a day. Now, I show you the results obtained with COMET's multiomics workflow. First, the automated detection on COMET of 12 plex RNAscope high plex positive and negative control targets utilizing T1 to T12 probe tails in 3 consecutive cycles on HeLa cell pellets. Each cycle uses 4 fluorescent channels, FIT-C, TRIT-C, Psi-5, and Psi-7. Positive control probes consist of housekeeping genes, whereas negative control probes target the bacterial gene BAP-B with T1 to T12 tails. Over here in panel A, we present a composite image of the overview of the HeLa cell pellet showing DAPI and 2 RNA targets detected with RNAscope SA. And over here on panel B on the right, you can see a side-by-side comparison that demonstrates the specificity of the 12 probes, again going from T1 to T12. Thus, RNAscope detection on COMET shows high specificity and positive control targets can be efficiently detected. Over here, on the next figure, I show you the co-detection of RNA and protein biomarkers on the same section of human FFP breast cancer tissue. First, here in panel A, example images of the 12-plex RNA panel used in multiomics protocol are shown here, detected by the RNAscope HiPlex Pro assay. And over here, in panel B, the 24-plex protein panel detected by sequential immunofluorescence on the same section on COMET. Next, I show you the co-detection of both signals, illustrating examples of cells co-detected by these two technologies: tumor-infiltrating lymphocytes, natural killer cells, myeloid lineage cells, T-cells expressing co-inhibitory receptors, and multiple stroma cells are identified with protein markers and characterized by staining for expressing specific transcripts, including secreted molecules. Moving on to the next figure over here, our results also demonstrate the high reproducibility of the COMET multiomics protocol. Highly reliable and robust RNA and protein detection results were obtained on COMET with RNAscope SA and sequential immunofluorescence in multiomics protocols performed on HeLa cell pellets. We performed inter-days, inter-devices, and inter-stainer reproducibility assays as represented over here in the left schematic. Panel B, C, and D show the reproducible results obtained with COMET for both RNA and protein targets. On the following figure over here, we see that given the punctual nature of the RNA signal, to make our workflow even more sensitive for RNA cycles, we implemented the possibility to acquire multiple Z-stack images with a selected number of steps and of a preferred size, which are then automatically processed via a maximum intensity projection, then aligned to the following images. This allows for a better resolution of high-density areas of high-expressed genes and a better capture of low-expressed signals. Finally, over here, on the last figure, we have an opportunity to showcase how the same section staining of protein, RNA, and HNE can enable a comprehensive view of cell phenotype and function. The top panels show you composite images of two types analyzed with 12-plex RNA plus 24-plex protein targets multiomics protocol automated on the COMET platform. Both tissues underwent HNE staining after the multiomics run. Thanks to the gentle assay conditions, the tissue morphology is well preserved after the multiomics assay on COMET. This will allow users to compare protein, RNA, and HNE in the same section. Then, according to the research question, a processed tissue section can be used for downstream applications. In conclusion, our results highlight the potential of spatial multiomics in enhancing research on immune cell biology and improving the understanding of cellular interplay within the tumor microenvironments. Full automation of RNA and protein co-detection on a platform such as COMET will accelerate the analysis and increase the robustness of findings by minimizing user intervention. Ultimately, spatial multiomics assay will help in the development of prognostic and predictive biomarkers in the refinement of cancer diagnosis and in the selection of novel personalized therapies. Thank you.